BBC Two. Now Brian Redhead presents the fourth programme that examines some of the implications of the new technological revolution, managing the micro.
Well, microelectronics is coming to the high street, but not quite as the Not the 9 o'clock news team saw it. There are dramatic changes on the way which will affect the way that many people work. And it is all to do with this. It is called a barcode. Now, there are already familiar sites on groceries and magazines and library books. And in this program, we'll be looking at some other applications as well. But first, let me explain how they work. They are very simply a quick way of getting information into a computer system. It's as if a machine could identify a person from his fingerprints, because that is in effect what they are, machine-readable fingerprints. And here is one of the machines that reads them. This sort of thing is in many libraries, but this one goes a bit further than most, and it actually tells us what it's thinking on this display here. Well now, when the light pen is wiped over the reader's ticket, the light from its tip is reflected off the series of lines and back onto a photo sensor, which is also in the pen. And because the thickness and the spacing of the lines varies, so the intensity of the reflected light varies, and that fluctuating signal is fed into the system circuitry, where it is recognized as a number unique to the owner, say me. It identifies my number on the ticket and then checks to see how many books I already have out. Let me do it. You pass it over the line, and there you can see it. Clear adult loans, 0+4. It means that I'm clear, I haven't stolen any books, that I'm an adult, that I'm allowed to borrow up to 4 books, and at the moment that I have none. Well, if I then offer the book, and the pen is passed over the book's barcode, like that, the computer matches the book to my card and tells the librarian how long I can keep it for. And you see, I can keep it until the 24th of June, 1981. Now, once that information is in the computer, it can be used in many ways. And the whole rigmarole of data processing can be applied at a distance. Theoretically, because individual borrowings can be entered into a memory in this way, it would be possible to know the whereabouts of every library book in Britain. We haven't actually arrived at that stage yet, but the technique does open up vast new opportunities for business because, as we shall see, that principle can be applied to many different processes. The barcode could be an instruction to a computer to perform a certain action, to open a valve, say, in an engineering works, or to move goods from one place to another, and it can all be done remotely. Now, one area that we've examined is the supermarket, where a similar device is coming into service at the checkout and thereby changing the whole process of running a store. But let's look first at the conventional methods, at what goes on now at Tesco's. The cashier has to read the price off every item, ring it up, and also remember to enter a department code. That's all recorded in the form of a string of numbers on a till roll, and it's difficult and time-consuming to extract from that any helpful sales data. In addition, every item has to be individually priced, because that's the only way the girl at the checkout knows what to ring up. Legally, this is the point of sale, where the price must be displayed, but not necessarily on every can. And somehow, price sticker machines and cardboard boxes do not seem to have been designed with each other in mind. Because the store doesn't have an accurate, up-to-the-minute picture of what it has sold, the only way it has of assessing its stock is actually to count all this lot every week. That is one of the jobs usually left to the rep. In this store, until he reports to the manager has only a rough idea of what he has in stock.
Morning.
Morning.
The rep offers to the manager of the store a suggested order, which is based on the state of the stock and on his guess at what people will want to buy next week.
Put your 100 down there because your bins are a bit low, so most of it comes straight up into stock there. Might appear a bit high to your sales ratio, but your bins are empty at the moment.
Plus we're on promotion at the moment.
Yeah, yeah.
And this, the order form, is the first piece of paper in a snowstorm of the stuff at head office. All the paperwork on these racks is necessary to keep Tesco's in business for just 1 week. Of course, they do know about computers at Tesco's. This is where the bits of paper are processed. But because it is still essentially a paper-driven system, it involves copying figures from paper onto the computer terminal, and every order, invoice, and delivery note has to be checked against the resulting printout. Perhaps the most significant piece of paper in the cycle is the delivery note, the one piece of evidence that the goods have changed hands. It's also significant that it's the one piece of paper in the cycle that's likely to survive as a result of the new technology, which is about to affect everyone whose job we've just seen. The storeman still has to count what's coming in the back door, just as the rep has to count what had gone out at the front. But Tesco's is one of a number of stores who are about to capitalise on the new electronic way of keeping track of the quantities entering or leaving the store, linking every part of the store one way or another into the computer network. Well, now let's see what happens when the cash register is linked into the store's computer system through the new laser scanning devices. When we shot the film, no supermarkets had got the whole system connected up, but two of them, Tesco's and Key Markets, are working towards the same goal from opposite directions, and we've made a composite picture from two of their stores. This is Key Markets store at Spalding, one of the first to use the new laser scanning point-of-sale checkouts. Because the goods carry a barcode, they no longer have to be individually priced. The barcodes on the goods are read by the laser scanner in the checkout desk, and the store computer, in effect, tells the till what the current price is for that particular item. That information is used in several ways. First, it appears on a display at the till. It's also printed on the till slip, so that customers have a more readable list of their purchases. But most important, it is used to generate a new order form, because the computer knows exactly how much stock the store is holding at any time. So, what will happen to the rep, now that he's no longer needed to count the stock each week?
I feel that the rep will do away with the less menial tasks that he has to carry out and make him a much more professional person for his company, in the fact that he'll be more interested in actually selling new products to me, discussing the business much more, and getting the most out of the products that he sells.
What we've got for you this time on the Fiesta, we've got the 20 extra sheets. You've had it once before. There's 10 extra per roll, which is clearly labelled on there, so there's no confusion.
Now that the computer can not only draw up the order, but also send it automatically down the telephone line, some people argue that the job of the rep will shrink so much that the number of reps needed will fall.
We used to have the flat ones, three in a pack.
At the back door, the delivery can be checked electronically against the computer's record of the order. I have with me two people who are concerned with this vision of the near future. John Flood, who is Deputy General Secretary of USDOR, that's the Shopworkers Union, and Donald Harris, who is a director of Tesco's. And Donald, first, I suppose the main attraction is that it's simply so much more efficient.
Indeed. We think that it'll provide customers with faster checkouts. We think the descriptive till slip is of benefit to them. And the ability to be more in stock of the good that customers want is a tremendous advantage.
And will that mean in the end that you'll sell more, do you think?
Well, we think so. If customers like shopping in the store, then they'll come in. If they come in, we will sell more.
Well, now, John, it'll be more efficient, but will it mean fewer jobs?
Most certainly, on the short term, it will mean
a dramatic reduction in the number of jobs at the lower end of the supermarket.
But will
the
that
shelf
mean,
fillers.
But that mean that the jobs that remain will be more interesting than the present jobs?
The jobs that remain will be more interesting. Many of them will call for a greater degree of skill and retraining to adapt to the new technology, and we certainly would be thinking that these new skills would merit higher reward.
I thought you might be thinking that. Now, while he's negotiating higher wages for the staff, what will you as a manager be doing when you haven't got all this paper to shove about?
Well, we see the store manager, rather than having to shuffle paper, having an opportunity to talk to his customers and look after his staff. And one of the things that one has to worry about is the position of the staff. And my company, I, on behalf of Tesco, gave an undertaking 18 months ago that there would be no compulsory redundancy with the introduction of new technology.
But will there be more sort of surveillance of the staff, looking down, seeing what they're doing, seeing how fast a girl is working at a checkout?
I think the measurement and productivity of staff is an important thing, but I think people like to be measured, and if they're measured and found good, then they should be rewarded for that.
I mean, do you see this being more competitive? I mean, girls competing perhaps for prizes even for being the best girl in the store.
Well, I don't see working in retailing being a competition by any manner of means. I think that it will lead to greater productivity, greater efficiency, and certainly one can only say that the companies who are investing millions of pounds in this must be quite certain of that, otherwise they wouldn't be going into it in the way they are.
I mean, are you certain that it's going to come?
Yes, I think this country can't duck it. We've got to accept that retailing will be affected by it, and many people would say that if you keep your head down, it'll go away. In us, though, we're not saying that. We say it's coming, it's right for the industry, it's right for the country, and our people should share in the benefits which will come from it.
Now, he's certain it's going to come, but you must be certain that it's going to be a benefit, otherwise your firm wouldn't be putting money into it.
Absolutely. We have been conducting trials since 1977, and we believe that there will be significant benefits to customer, staff, and shareholders.
And we're being very solemn about it. Won't it also be really rather an exciting new world?
Oh, yes. Well, the change is very interesting. The acceptance of new technology generally is very exciting, and witness things like washing machines, which now have programs in them and run on chips. So, yes, there are big changes coming, and the changes are interesting, without question.
And any attitude to resist it, would you regard as Ludditism, or would you feel that a union will have to walk very carefully through this?
Well, we're approaching this thing with, I think someone said, with a great deal of confidence mixed with caution. And I think that is the best approach. We certainly are going into it very thoroughly. We're looking for planning agreements, technology agreements, and we're certainly speaking not only for the retail staff, but for the consumer, because we believe that once it bites, it will bring a new dimension as far as the customer's concerned, as well as a new dimension to the retail worker.
But can we say farewell to the commercial traveller?
I don't think so. What it says is that the skills that the commercial traveller requires will have to be upgraded, and that he will have to be a better person at his job.
Good. Well, now, this method of data capture, as the jargon for it is called, is happening not only in the retail trade, but in the manufacturing industry as well. Now, we went to British Leyland, BL, where exactly the same principle is in use, but it is monitoring the flow of people as well as of things.